we're watching the TRG. Ooh. We bring in the family. Yeah. You're watching the TRG. Yeah. We bring in the family. Let's go. We carving a brand new niche for direct relief on a Twitch TV. Video games bring us together. Woo. You can find us online whenever. Turn off the jokes, turn off the pressure, turn off the heat. We in the nether. We make a lot of innuendos while we're playing the Nintendos. Moon is shining through the windows. Here with my friendos, rising crescendos. Yeah. A high score, you'll be gun bopped at. An encore, you'll be gun comeback. We might soar up like the NASDAQ. Get a lot of flavor here like a spice rack. First, let's start with our boy. You know who it is, that's Sugar Conroy. Voice so loud and a pun so coy. If he's out here, then you're gonna hear noise. And he got a lot of depth like his Let's Plays. Selling you on a game like Billy Mays. You can watch him for days on days. Once you start, can't stop, bag of lays. Pack his speed always and it's on delays. Pause the play, oh, we got moves for days. Built up strong in a lot of ways. Been here for a long time, here to stay. Consistency, that's how you blaze. Quality content without delays. He's gonna be killed by my girl, Mercedes. I said what I said, no paraphrase. Next, please get off his lawn. Don't get on the bad side of Proton John. Working all night to the Proton Dawn. Looking more gorgeous than a Proton Swan. So many games, a collection of beauty. Community, he always on duty. He's a great sport, but sometimes whiny, moody, and just a little snooty. He can be the boss with a small hitbox. Get a large network that crisscross. Cat named Big Gold, that a big boss. If you don't know him, then it's your loss. He is an OG, he got mad sauce. Thrown controllers, he made it take off. Who made it take off? Let's go, Mazel Tov! Woo, pop off! If you wanna have fun, get into the Capri Sun. He's a Let's Play Dad, I'm the prodigal son. Let's play videos, he's made a damn ton. He is a guy, he's on the run. He is a wife, and number one. His videos aren't a one and done. If you want bucks, well he's got none. His videos are recommended. His humor crappy, pun intended. His personality very splendid. In the background, acting candid. Oh so happy, make a room laugh. He is a Jedi with a blue staff. Get a riffraff, passing that gas. He started this shiz, he's the upper class. Upper class, got a lot of years in the upper class. Got a lot of views in the upper class. OGs out here that'll make you laugh. Upper class, got a lot of years in the upper class. Got a lot of views in the upper class. OGs out here that'll make you laugh. You're watching the TRG. Yeah. We bring in the family. Let's go. We carving a brand new niche for direct relief on a Twitch TV. Video games bring us together. Woo. You can find us online whenever. Turn up the jokes, turn up the pressure, turn up the heat, we in the nether. Okay. Okay. What? So happy.
I'll take banana bread, heck yeah.
Hey Rowan, how's it going, buddy?
What's up, man?
So, I'm looking for some games. Would you all happen to have Lego Titanic by any chance?
I don't think so, bud.
No? Okay. What about GTA NB?
NB?
North Bergen.
Where'd you get these, Dan?
Well, I found this list online. So, Tollbooth Simulator? That's not...
No.
No? Okay. I mean, it sounded fun. Elmo's Pub Crawl?
Elmo? Like Sesame Street Elmo?
Yeah.
We count in pints?
Yeah, now that I said it out loud, it's,
I gotta finish this trade, bud. I'm sorry, bud.
Alright, well, good luck with the trade. I'll see you at some point later. Sorry.
Later, Dan. Money.
Yeah, I'll have sausage, egg, and cheese McMuffin.
And do you know if they have blue milk on this planet?
Have what?
Blue milk.
No, I don't. I'm sorry.
Okay, I'll take a chocolate milk then.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Anything else?
Nope, that should do it.
It'll be 42 at the first window. Have a great day.
Thank you. There you go.
Thank you. There you go.
All right. May the force be with you.
Have a good day. Would you like a straw for your taco milk?
No, that's fine.
What?
That's fine. I'm fine.
Have a
great day. Awesome. May the force be with you. Well, that was certainly a thing.
So a lot of people ask me a lot of questions, but one of the ones I've been getting a lot lately is, what's it like having a VTuber as a wife?
It's really no different. She loves to clean. She's good to cuddle. And she loves streaming on Twitch.
What the?
You know, normal stuff.
Little help?
On my way. Hey, Reese, I gotta test out that cosplay makeup. Is everything in the bathroom for me?
Yeah, it's all there.
All right, cool. Do I actually need all of this?
Yeah.
Everything?
Yes.
All right, you're the professional. I think I did it wrong.
Do you have it in reverse?
Oh. Okay. Oh. Hey, it worked. Cool. Thanks, hon. Wait, how did this change my clothes?
What's Jiggy thinking about?
Paper Mario Sticker Star is a decent enough game.
Yo, did you get your bumper yet?
No.
Bumper. Do it. What's your bumper?
I got it! Hi, I'm Emil Chugga Conroy, and you're watching TRG. TRG!
You can't do that.
Why not?
That's Adriana's bumper from last year.
It is?
Yep.
Alright, man, let's open up this pit, yo!
What? Don't break your house! You can't do that either, that's Jax!
Oh.
Also, are those my glasses?
Maybe.
Give me my glasses back!
It needs 2 stars. I only have 1.
Emil!
It's like in the video game. Isn't that zany?
Stop!
I, for one, find it quite poggers. Welcome to the Runaway Guys Coliseum. Everybody's here.
That's Tom's.
But I was gonna introduce you first.
Oh no.
Jules, where's the butter?
Butter? What butter?
I know you were sneaking butter. I saw the extra bag. That
I had no idea what you mean, Jack.
I saw the butter in the bathroom. Like, no, you're crazy. You love butter too much. It's
I know like butter. Like, I know that I'm very particular about my diet. And because especially like right now, I mean, with all the quarantining, like it's just like a lot to do, and there's a lot.
No, I would never
just take the butter, Jack. No,
you're always the one who is swimming with butter.
Why would I even bring butter into the bathroom? It doesn't make any sense.
I'm composed of like matter, and I'm not a walking steak of butter. I still matter. Okay,
I'm not like, even though I'm not maybe what you're saying butter, and I don't think it's
I'm
right,
still important.
Honestly, like,
I should
even,
be treated valuably,
like butter.
Just like your precious
butter. You've never even
seen
me for 20 hours.
Private
time.
Investigator.
It doesn't even make any sense. It's secret investigators. What?
You no,
dude,
I know
so
you got butter.
Up.
I know you have secret undercover sources.
Like okay, like you know,
you have
like
butter, like
network
of black butter market. Why are there pancakes next to the jacuzzi,
dude? All.
Hey everyone, it's Sab Irene here. I'm super excited to be back for another TRG Coliseum. Some of you may know me as one of the musicians for TRG, but something you might not know is that I actually speak some Japanese. And I bet some of you here are thinking, oh gosh, golly gee, I wish I could speak Japanese. Well, today's that day. I'll be offering some basic phrases that you can practice throughout this entire weekend. So, let's start with some simple phrases, starting with Konnichiwa, ogenki desu ka? Okashi o tabete imasu. Inu ga daisuki desu. Here are a few more complex words. Ojii-san, oba-san, rampu, uma no oka-san. And if you really want to impress your friends, you can say, Dareka riku o hikimasu ka?
Kono hito wa hanshu kifusha desu ka? John wa ikutsu no game wo motte imasu ka?
Otoko no hito wa nani wo tabete imasu ka? I hope you learned some helpful Japanese to get you through this weekend. Ja, mata ne!
Ships, medical aid, and supplies across the world. You respond to disasters like hurricanes and earthquakes and bushfires. Direct Relief is sending relief to medical centers assisting with COVID-19 pandemic. They distributed 1.3 billion of aid so far. 100% of donations are in. Humanitarian aid organization active in 50 states and more than 80 countries with the mission to improve the health and lives of people affected by poverty or emergencies without regard to politics, religion, or ability to pay.
So yeah, that's why I'm banned from Magic Mountain for life.
Yo guys, John is gonna cosplay as Rosa.
Oh yeah, we heard. Anyway, as you all know, I was in a mess of trouble.
Yeah. Oh, heck yeah.
Yeah, it's gonna be so cool.
Oh, I bet it's going to be a magical transformation.
Yo, that's so cute! Ah!
I was kind of in the middle of a story here.
Hold on. How about if we added a little more science? Something like...
Ooh. Ooh, let me build on this. That transformation's good, but it needs a little bit more action. So how about something like...
Ooh, nice.
Ah. I have an idea.
No.
No!
No, no.
Yeah, that's fair.
Okay, well, I think it would be more epic. Picture this. Pitch black. Light slowly turning on to reveal a massive...
Hang on. That's not even John turning into Rosa.
Yeah, it's not.
Guys, let me explain, okay? Okay, so it's kind of obvious.
No, superheroes are some of the oldest media works of fiction. Yeah, it would make more sense to come with that rather than Rosa John than it would be to just be a magical.
Guys,
superheroes.
Yo, chuckleheads, why don't we just, I don't know, ask John?
Oh.
Yep. That makes sense.
Guys, it's. Just a costume. I'm just gonna put it on. It's clothing. There's nothing complex about this.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, that thing, yeah. Mm.
Thanks, John.
What was that about?
Oh, just more people asking how the hell I'm gonna put on your costume.
You still haven't told them we're all real and that I'm screaming instead?
No, I don't think at this point anyone would believe me.
Eh, okay. Wanna play Mario Kart?
Yeah, sure.
You know, when I first got a puppy, I really didn't know what kind of untapped potential I was going to have with it. And by which I mean he's got the largest amount of BPE, or big puppy energy, that I've ever seen in any creature before. I mean, I've owned dogs in the past, and none of them were as energetic as little Manatee here. I mean, he chews on like plushes, my clothes, the woodwork, me. He's chewed on my hands before. And just the running, just the constant running, it's so difficult to get anything done. So what I thought was, maybe I could find something that he'll chase around that doesn't use up terribly much of my energy, so I'd still be able to do things like get work done. Well, one day when I was cleaning up, I noticed he was very attracted to one particular thing. So I thought, okay, what if I just continually use that thing until he ran out of energy? I think that'd be a good way to kind of get him to calm down a little bit and for me to also be able to get some work done. So, let's give it a shot. Okay, so that didn't quite work out as well as I thought, but, I mean, the house has never been cleaner.
What's Jiggy thinking about?
Chef Emil.
Hi.
Are you ready to make chugga cookies?
No.
Great. So Emil's not good at cooking.
Yes. That's one thing you got right.
Emil has tried many times. There has been many incidents.
I'm not good, and the story behind this is that we were visiting Steven and Mal one time. Mal wanted me to make a skillet cookie with her so I could learn how to make that. And we're making it, and we need 3 sticks of butter for this. And I go, wow, cookies have a lot of butter in them. And then she goes, yeah, what did you think it was? And I was like, I don't know, water and flour and stuff? So that's what prompted this.
Yeah, so what Emil's gonna do today is try to make cookies without looking at a recipe. Are you ready? Trust your instincts. Explain your process.
Okay, so I'm gonna get... So I can't even look at, like, proportions or anything.
Nope. You have to guess.
Okay, so I'll start by opening the flour. A cup of flour, that sounds like a pretty standard measurement of something. That's pretty close. Shut up. I just put in flour! There's flour, right?
Continue.
I mean, there's naturally going to be a lot of sugar in this. I eat a lot of cookies, but I don't make a lot of cookies. Like, the flour is like the base of the whole thing, so there's going to be less sugar than flour, right? So, like, a half cup? Like, I can't use butter because I didn't know there was butter in it at the time. That is in the rules, yes?
No, use butter.
Okay.
But you're making cookies in the way that you think that it should be made.
Okay. The skillet cookie was really big, and I had, like, 3 sticks of butter in it, so if I'm making, like, a cookie sheet of cookies, maybe I could do, like, a stick and a half or something? Have, like, 2 sticks of butter in it, I guess. Watch me discover, like, some really great new recipe. Maybe I could put the butter in the microwave to, like, loosen it up a little bit before I mix it. That sounds like a thing you do. Okay, so let's dunk that in. Dill pickle mustard. Okay.
Oh my god.
Maybe there was like a pinch of salt? I don't know. That sounds right, I think.
Gonna need to add some water to this.
What are you cooking about? I mean, it kind of looks like cookie dough. I think I remember there being like eggs in this though, but I'm not so sure of that.
I will give you no hints.
I'll add an egg. I guess add an egg. I know there's a reason why you don't want to eat this raw. And like, water, sugar, flour, and butter don't sound like reasons to not eat it raw. So like, I think you put like an egg in it, maybe two? Two. Yes, two. I gotta commit to things. I gotta not be so just like skirting around everything. I need to just do.
I mean, like, it kind of looks like dough. Yeah, it looks more dough-like now.
Okay, I think I could maybe use this to scoop it out and, like, make cookie-sized things with it. This is non-stick already, though, but I probably, like, I don't trust my own creation to not stick. Are we gonna auction one of these off for charity?
Oh my god.
They probably need medical attention from direct relief when this is over. Okay. I hear you laughing.
I did no such thing.
All right, are you gonna give me a temperature to like cook this at?
Nope.
Good
luck.
All right, I should have preheated this before like all the good chefs do on TV. Let's go with 375.
How you feeling about your creation? There
ketchup
it is.
Ketchup packets.
No. Oh god, please don't do that. There it is.
Okay.
So how long do you think we keep it in the
oven?
I
was just gonna watch it and see when it looked done.
Give us an estimate.
But I would guess like 20 minutes.
20 minutes, okay.
That's my guess. It sounds like a nice, safe time.
Okay.
I probably will step away for 10 minutes.
I will not.
You gonna time lapse this?
Well, more importantly, I'm gonna make sure your house doesn't burn down. So you're welcome.
This is not going. Nothing is flammable about butter and water and flour. Tell you what. You stay here and watch, I'll go get the fire extinguisher.
There they go.
My children.
Oh, man. How confident are you?
Paper Mario sticker star.
That's a horrible thing to say about your children.
They're a terrible disappointment.
Whoa! Oh no, wait.
What? What? Oh my god!
Oh my god! Wait!
Oh no!
It has been maybe a minute and a half.
Oh no!
Emil!
No!
I don't think that's what you wanted to have.
No!
Oh my god.
Oh no!
I was trying to get the phone on the
tripod.
Well,
we're having cobbler.
Oh my god. Oh my.
We looked away for 1 minute.
It might run over.
It probably is.
Oh no, Emil.
I see smoke.
Yep. Hey, remember when you were gonna leave for 10 minutes? It has been 5.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
I'm gonna leave for 10 minutes. 5 minutes later, it starts smoking.
I mean, it kinda looks like cookie viscosity.
Cookie viscosity? Alright.
Turn the fan on because it started smoking. Oh my god.
Oh no.
Oh Jesus.
It's not on fire.
Say that it burst into flames in my hands.
It's dripping, it's dripping.
Okay, well, the stove's gonna get cleaned in like the next day. Did we let it cool for a bit?
Poke it?
Like, it's kind of cookie-ish.
Do you want to throw it back in, or?
I'm scared to throw it back in because that was a lot of smoke. Okay, I didn't think that flour and water and sugar in the oven at a reasonable temperature could possibly, like, create smoke if it wasn't in there for, like, an hour. I thought that was just cartoons.
Well, welcome to real life.
Okay, so I guess we'll chop that. I say it like I'm gonna eat this entire segment.
gonna get you for this.
Not me!
It comes apart more the more I try to pick it up.
Jesus. Oh no.
It kind of looks like cornbread.
Like it looks like nothing like
chocolate
cornbread.
Chip cornbread.
Looks nothing like cornbread.
Do I go?
If you think, yeah.
Do I boldly go? Oh my god, it smells like an egg. Okay, if I'm being honest, it kind of tastes like an omelet with ketchup on it.
Oh my god!
Are you gonna try a little?
No.
Really? Just take a little bit of it. That's all I'm asking.
Oh, good. It's spongy!
Yes, it is.
Oh god, it's so spongy!
Okay, it's bad, but it's not as bad as I thought it was going to be when it started, like, falling over the edges and all that.
Yeah, you know, it actually reminds me of something, too. Oh, I mean...
Like, I think it tastes like an omelet, personally, with, like, a little bit of sweetness to it.
Yeah, it totally tastes like an omelet. A really weird textured omelet.
Yeah. Alright, well, this has been, Chef Master? I don't know, like, what you want to call it.
Chuga cookies! Make some at home!
Please don't. Recovers 1 HP and 1 FP.
Alright, bye.
Hey, you see this? Is it on camera?
Uh-huh.
Now it's Ryan time!
Please stop!
Ugh, man, I don't know, dude. Just, like, what is the purpose, you know? Like, what is the meaning? This is the meaning, Jack. I mean, don't you think so? Don't you think the purpose of life and everything is to just do your best every single day? I think a lot of people might think that they don't quite live up to their potential, or they might not think that they might not be good enough for the people around them, the people that they love, and themselves. But I think you should just give yourself a little bit of a break, because I think every single day that you even try just a little bit, that's more than enough. And I think just by helping things like direct relief, PRG Coliseum, donating to a great cause, I think that's a huge difference, and that makes a great purpose. And I think that's what you should focus on.
What's Jiggy thinking about?
All right, everyone, let's settle down. Time to get down to business. So, today's an important day. The TRG musical crew is in need of some extra musical talent. And today's audition day, we've got a... Where's the list? There it is. We got a pretty promising list of contenders, so let's just get down to it. Time for the first one, Mr. Mario. Yes, Mr. Mario, it sounds really good. But according to my records right here, it looks like you're supposed to be dead.
Huh? Mamma mia!
Hey, everybody, I'm Luigi. Today I'm going to play the drums for you. Here we go. Oh.
sounds fantastic. Here, you think you can play this chart for me?
Sheet music? Donkey Kong, no, read sheet music!
Wow, what a hot beat! I'm Sonic the Hedgehog, and today I'm gonna use my speed to play the drums faster than you've ever seen before. Here we go! Try to catch me now, Eggman! Can you guys do anything else besides play the sleigh bells? Now step on the balance board and relax your entire body. Take in a deep breath as you raise your left leg. Really feel the vibrations as you let the air flow. Okay, next up is a Mr. Game and Watch. Whew, tough crowd today. All right, looks like we've got about one more. Mr. Lamp, are you ready to go?
Oh hey, what's up? I didn't see you there. Hey, what's up? What's that? You want to learn some music theory with me, Toxic X Eternity, teaching you music theory? All right, let's go over some music theory. Let's do this. Let's start with the basics. Here is a C chord. So we all know that the fourth letter of the alphabet is C, which of course would mean that B is the fourth interval of C. And when you're making complex harmony structure, you have to remember that the third tritone is always complete. So let's talk about eighth notes. You should never use eighth notes. Eighth notes are wrong and you should never use them. Seriously. never use an eighth note.
Let's move on. So now that we got the basics out of the way, let's check up on one of our star pupils, Mr. Family Jewels.
Hey, what is he doing there, sport?
Doing some scales.
He got, the Wumbo Sidian scale.
That's one of my favorites.
But Jewels, why are you playing scales on a guitar? You're not supposed to be playing scales. Do you know what you're supposed to be doing as a guitar player?
What?
That's right, everybody. You should be playing chords. Okay. And also,
open up this
pillet!
Jack, come on. 2047, whatever year it is, donate today, let's go!
Hi, I'm Thomas Tighe, President and CEO of Direct Relief. Just wanted to say thank you to the Runaway guys and everyone watching the Runaway guys raise money for Direct Relief to help out in India. We are here in Newark, New Jersey airport tonight at the FedEx terminal, where they've been gracious enough to donate a 777 cargo jet to fly 100 tons of oxygen concentrators and masks, N95, KN95 masks to Mumbai tomorrow. So when I heard about what you were doing, we're deeply thankful to what FedEx is doing and very, very thankful to what all y'all are doing. Having a lot of fun doing it, I saw. So just want to say thank you. Keep it up. Way to go.
All right, everybody. I'll see you all tomorrow for Runaway Guys Coliseum Day 3. Bye, everybody. Oh, thank God. I can get out of this and go home. What is that? Have you been here all weekend?
Yeah, I've been playing Bacross here all weekend.
This was your emergency?
Bacross is an emergency. What do you want?
All right, cool, but I have to go home, so you need to go run your segment for the last day.
No, honestly, you've been doing a pretty good job. I've been watching. You should do the third day, too.
All right, you asked for it.
What are you going to do, use your magic on me? Oh, crap.
God. Okay, fine. Fine. Go do my damn shift.
I swear we like each other.
We're the same person.
Hell yeah. So stoked, dude. Wait, they didn't give me any hot sauce.
Oh, I got you, bro.
Whoa.
What's Jiggy thinking about?
I'm not going to do that at all. I'm just going to loop with the same dignity I've had for the last however long I've been doing this.
Yes. I must say, I marvel at everything that you have been doing up until this point.
Have you?
Yes.
Well, however, if I don't get a question, I'm glad you're doing this. You can't hide in a cave for the rest of your life.
That is so true.
No, 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 yes.
Will you still continue to slide up and down the pole?
Thank you.
And if we hit 335,000, I will get a swirly from Jack. It has to be by the end of this song. Here we go. We did it!
Alex from Shadowlands!
And I have to go get swirlied, so...
TRT Coliseum, you donated for this!
Charity. Donate to Direct Relief!
What's Jiggy thinking about?
Where did I put all those frames from day one? Oh! I didn't see you there. Hi, I'm MC. I'm one of the production specialists. Hello. I'm MC, the Stream God, here to share with you some tips from my Stream God Bible. Never obstruct vital gameplay elements, so don't put your webcam over the hearts. Remember, if there's a lot of action on stream, you want to go with 60 FPS and nothing lower.
Thinking about making an upgrade? Remember, it's always worth it to upgrade the
audio before you upgrade the video. Remember, if you have guests on stream, some of them will speak at a different volume than yours. So always be ready to turn down their volume slider. Don't forget to let your audience know where to follow me on Twitch. Make sure you go over to Twitter. You can follow there. There's a tip thing coming out soon. YouTube, subscribe. Hey, MySpace, I'm dropping a new single. Upvote me on Dig. Thank you very much. Always be prepared for something exciting to happen on stream and be ready to do your best poggers. Remember, DMCA is a real thing and you have to be cautious. Even your favorite band can get you. Are you having a hard time figuring out what game to play on stream? Try Hades. Hades. You should play Hades, seriously. Play Hades. Would you like to borrow mine? You can have it. Here you go. Having lighting issues? You can't see your face well on stream? Well, just buy more RGB. It won't fix your problem, but RGB! And lastly, during your streams, always remember to hydrate often.
Hello. Okay. All right, so we are going to do
some
yoga. So I'd like to invite everybody to take a second. We've had a lot of excitement this weekend already, about halfway through. Let's take a second to just sit down, maybe on the ground, maybe on some kind of pad if you have a yoga mat, or even just a pillow. We're going to take a second. We're going to close our eyes. We're going to sit up straight. Let your back, your spine be completely straight. Take a big deep breath in and out through your mouth. Breath in through your nose. Out through your mouth. And as you're breathing, I want you to imagine everything on your body kind of hanging on your spine, almost like through the clothes of your spine, just kind of relaxed, effortlessly hanging off of your skeleton. Think about all those tense parts of your body, any stress that you're holding on to. Allow those things to fall off. Continue to breathe. Now begin to notice your thoughts as they go by. Don't stop them, but notice each thought as it goes by, kind of like traffic on a road. Just watch the car go by and then drift off into nothingness. And allow your head to just be empty. On your next breathe out, move your head down and breathe in. Keep your back straight. Breathe in. Then on your exhale, you're going to turn your head to your right. We're going to roll our head to the left side very slowly on an exhale. Stay in this moment here, right after your exhale, and then inhale, and then to the right side. Keep on breathing and turn your body to the right. Keep your back straight. Scoot forward. And lie back. Continue to breathe. Be aware of any thoughts you have. Maybe they're positive, maybe they're negative. Doesn't matter. Just notice them. Observe the thoughts. Take one more scoot up, forward. And then what we're going to do is we're going to put our arms out. Stretch up. Breathe in, breathe out. And put your arms down. And we're gonna take our legs and we're going to flip them up
and eat some ass. Yeah. Alright, so now that you're in this position, what you're gonna wanna do is make sure that you're not overexerting your neck or any part of your body. If when you talk, you sound like I do, you're overexerting your body. Make sure you're breathing inward and then outward, and then, make sure you're aware of the thoughts that are going through your head. Yeah, very good. Great job. Alright.
Okay. Alright. Great. Good work. Good work. Alright, this has been Mealtime with Family Jewels.